Shout out to the nation out there, it's your girl Deanna Diaz, entrepreneur and purpose influencer. I'm here to give business advice based on my experience. So let's get ready to show up and show out. Today we're going to be talking about business development with customer relations and engagement. So if you want to know more about that to enhance your business, make sure you keep on watching. There is exactly six things that I want to explain in this video today. So with no further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Number one, what is a customer? Merriam-Webster defines a customer as an individual usually having some specified distinctive taste. Google defines a customer as a person or organization that buys goods or services from a store or business. Now, both of those are obviously very true, but I want to definitely focus on the Merriam-Webster version. Number two is gather as much information as possible on the customer. So, being that we know the customer is somebody with a distinct trait, that means this is where we break them down. Are they a single mother? Does this person like luxury brands? Does this person like to bargain shop? Does this person play sports? Does this person sit at home all day? Those are specific traits that your customer has. The next part of that is, what kind of problems are they having? What kind of situations are they facing that your product or service can make them better? So, for example, I know with my personal nail business, single moms for me who are really busy do well for me because they don't have time to sit in the salon. They don't want to worry about their kids or finding a babysitter or things like that. So that's just an example. That's just one part of the customer base that I have. Another part of that is, do they like to feel chic? Do they like to feel luxurious? I design nails that help them feel just that. You know what I mean? So you have to break down your customer. All right, you guys. Number three is ask for feedback. Now, if you're brand new, spanking new, just starting out, you're really not going to have that much feedback to get at the moment. What you can do is you can either hold a focus group. If you need more information on how to hold a focus group, let me know and I can do a video on that or do a blog about that. You can hold a focus group or you can just throw caution in the wind and just send your product out. And I don't 100% fault this at all because that's how you're going to get an honest opinion and feedback on your product. So once you get that feedback, make sure you take it with a grain of salt and use it to your advantage to do better. An example for feedback being successful for you is Amazon. All through Amazon, on each and every product, mostly the ones that at least been selling for the past few years, it has feedback on it. It has a star rating. The more stars and or ratings that that product has on Amazon, the more it attracts more buyers to it, and it'll attract more customers in your customer profile to it. So that is another reason why you want to collect feedback. Another way to get feedback is to send emails that they can answer anonymously. So what I did was I went into Google Forms and I created a simple feedback form, a star rating, would you recommend to your friends, what did you like, what didn't you like, things like that. So I created that simple form, no more than 10 questions, I'm sure, on Google Forms, and I sent those to the customers that have purchased from me in the past or before or recently, and I asked them to submit that form, and I let them know on the form that it was definitely anonymous, so I won't know who sent it back, because you know some people feel like you may become biased against them or whatever. So, but I gave my customers the opportunity to give me feedback anonymously, and as you can see, I'm sending out something, the customer is sending me back something, and we are engaging with each other because we're only going to make each other more happier the more we do that. Speaking of engagement, that's going to bring us to our next point, which is number four, using social media to converse with your customers and potential customers. You will notice that I talk about social media engagement or social networking a lot within my videos. That's only because it is so important, especially for right now. And I guarantee it's going to always be important, all right? Especially with technology and things like that. But I say that to say that when I use social media and I'm in these different Facebook groups, and you'll hear me talk about that a lot too, I'm in these different Facebook groups that have to do with the beauty industry, single moms group. I'm in groups where it's like military females, because I am a vet. A lot of these women, they may be active duty or things like that. And some of them are nurses and other professions like that, where they cannot have their nails done. So that's where I post my tidbits. I don't just blatantly promote my stuff like that. I do make it make sense and I ease it into the conversation. That is something that you definitely have to learn, the art of conversation. So when I speak to these different women, and even some guys, they recommend their wives or girlfriends to me, and we connect that way. But when I'm in these groups, I definitely make sure to have a conversation, and I see where they're coming from. I see what they want, and I see what they need. I try to figure out what their style is, and then, you know, that's when I go ahead and I go slide my virtual business card with my virtual storefront right in there. So, and I'm getting that back and forth feedback, because what happens is, and what has happened, a lot of potential customers, they'll go on my website, they'll check it out, and I can see where they pop up on there, and then they'll come back on that social media post and they'll say, I like your work. Your work is bomb. Your work is this. Your work is great. And guess what? Somebody else comes along and sees that comment. Even though the person that had originally went on there from that post didn't necessarily buy something right then and there, that doesn't mean the next person won't. And that attracts more customers to me. So make sure you're having a conversation to get that engagement on social media. All right, number five, what you're going to want to do is reward the customer. This happens after you brought them into your circle. You made them a part of your family. You want to go ahead and continuously reward the customer. Now, a way that I do this is every time that I send out an order, I have my little 4x6 flyer in there that they usually post with their nails on their social media. But I also have a little thank you card with a percentage discount off for their next order. So they feel like they're already winning without having to buy 6, 7, a dozen sets from me, which would be awesome. But without having to spend so much money with me, they instantly get that reward, and that makes them feel real good inside. I've heard a lot of feedback because of that. So give a reward to your customer. The last and final tip that I have for you all, and number six, is under promise and over deliver. You do not have to break the bank to do this, okay? What I did to do this promise, when I used to run my boutique, which is Bangles Boutique, every time I sent out an order, I would send a small pair of fabric button earrings, and everybody loved it. They were not expecting it. And then I wrote a little note, thank you for shopping with me. Enjoy the free gift that I give to my loyal customers. So this gives the element of surprise. They never know what they're going to get next time they order. They might get something else. You know, their mind starts running and they're real excited about that. So you can do this with services as well. When you complete a basic service, then you might throw in a gift or whatever. You might do a special, a surprise buy one, get one special, things like that. You never know. The possibilities are endless, so make sure that you under-promise but over-deliver. It makes the customer feel so appreciated, I promise you. All right, you guys, let's go ahead and do a quick recap. Number one, what is a customer? We already know that that is someone with a specified distinctive trait. Number two, get as much information on your customer as possible. Number three, ask for feedback. Number four, use social media to converse with your customers and future customers. Number five, reward loyal customers. Number six, under promise and over deliver. I wanted to take the time to thank you guys for watching my video. I'm up late filming this, but I wanted to do it because I wanted to do this for you all. So I want all y'all to be successful. Keep grinding. Don't stop until you get enough. But even when you get enough, just keep on going. So I see y'all in the next video. Thank you so much. And shout out to UD Nation. If you have not subscribed yet, make sure that you subscribe today. Make sure you go over to my website, theanideas.com, and make sure you're subscribed up that site because I got some great things coming up. So, I'll see y'all next time.